Okay, but you come back to me. I'm not trying to fight you. I apologize for my pimple. I know it's probably really disgusting and like you're probably just like staring at it, but who cares? I think she's gonna fall asleep now. So, it's Alyssa here. Not that you didn't already know my name. If you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe, because why watch my videos if you're not even gonna subscribe to me? Because, you know, it'd be really nice. It made no sense. Society today. So this is the way I see the world of like how my generation is right now. I'm 14, going into ninth grade. So this is how I see my generation. This is how I see my generation through friendships and relationships and everything. Okay, so starting with friendships.
Why was that so smooth? And why am I doing some like Karate Kid freaking yoga or something?
The way I see things now for like friendships is that most of us will try to find the popular group to be friends with, or like a fake group to be friends with, just to come off as cool to everyone else, so that way more people will like you, because you know popularity is a really big thing now where everybody just wants to be popular. We all pick groups that aren't the best for us. They're just not ever there for you. We just hang out with them to make us cool, when really it'd be a lot better to just have like one friend who's like really there for you and is real with you and can make you feel better. And friends are like what kind of build us up. They help us through things. They're there to talk to us about our problems. They're there to tell us when we're doing something wrong or when we're not doing something wrong. So nowadays, a lot of us don't really find someone like that. A lot of us just really find fake friends so that way we can be cool. We pick the wrong people to be friends with. We don't really find someone that we really like in a way, I guess. That sounds really bad. I guess there are still a few people who still find those friends that are really amazing to each other. Relationships, your love life. I honestly wish every love life could be like the Grease in the 60s. Like, honestly, nowadays people don't really look forward to a future with you. Or now in my generation, people don't really see a future with you. They just see what's happening there and what they want now. Just horny little disgusting kids, pretty much. A lot of us are just really horny. We're not really looking for someone that we see a future with. We're just looking for someone that we can mess around with for now, I guess. Which is kind of sad. And if you're not one of those people, if you're one of those people who dates to be in a relationship for like ever so you can marry them and like have a strong bond with them, then you're awesome, because I look for that too, but I can't find anybody like that. This is for guys. They'll automatically ask for nudes, or they're really horny or just want to get alone time with you to go have sex with you or do lots of weird things. Or girls even, they see a cute guy and they'll probably end up like sending a picture to them, a picture of the boobs or something to that guy just because they think he's cute or whatever. That fast, when you really shouldn't do it that fast, because it's kind of dumb. For you girls that like sending pictures, I say make sure you at least like send them to someone you trust and that you know isn't gonna go show everyone and call you names once you stop sending or something like that, because you don't want that happening. To be honest with you, nowadays we're all kind of like little whores. We're in a rush to hurry up and grow up, when really I think we should just like stay little, because I don't want to grow up. It's sad. You have to start with your bills, buy your house, your car, your job. You get really stressed out. So like, be happy now. Live your life doing fun things. Don't live your life getting stuck on girls or boys. Don't live your life trying to find someone to love you. Don't live your life being sad. Don't live your life putting yourself down. Just don't get yourself stuck in relationships that you know aren't gonna last forever. And stop trying to grow up already. Just be happy with what you have in the moment. And when I say live your life and do fun things, make like crazy choices, I don't mean like go get drunk or go do a bunch of crazy drugs. Go do like, you know, stuff like that. Don't go having sex with like 10 guys just because it feels good. Go have fun with friends. Go to creeks, lakes, go to the beach, go on trips, go make little adventures with people, go laugh, go out on dates. Not really dates. I just don't really go out on dates because boys are dumb. Girls are dumb too. I feel like a hippie. Be a hippie. There you go. Be a hippie. We'd all be better if we were just hippies. If we were all vegan. Or vegetarian. I thought about going vegan once. But the thing is that all my parents buy is meat. There is nothing that we have. Well, there are a few things that we have that like can help you go vegetarian, but like I want to go vegetarian, but none of my family does. So how am I supposed to be vegetarian when my family's just going to buy a bunch of meat and not going to help me buy any foods that I need? You know, I'm just going to starve. So I'm not going vegetarian until I'm out of the house and living on my own. We compare ourselves to models or people on the internet who are famous and have like a bunch of people liking them and have like this big fan base or whatever. We compare ourselves to those type of people. We push ourselves down so much because of it. And like you see all these models and stuff, they even have something that's bothering them, even if they don't want to admit it. Everyone has something that they don't like about themselves. Not all models are natural. Not one person in this world is satisfied with everything about them. You know, they all wish they had something more. Everyone wishes they had something more, whether they admit it or not. Don't spend so much time worrying about what other people think of you or trying to make yourself look better. I guess it's okay to make yourself like look nice and everything, but don't go fake. It's okay to wear makeup sometimes, and it's okay to like go all curl your hair and wear nice clothes and like show a little skin or whatnot, but just don't do it all the time. It's okay not to wear makeup sometimes. Like, it's okay to express your natural beauty, and if someone doesn't like that about you, then they're not seeing things. That's not the person that's for you, you know? There is someone out there who likes seeing you without your makeup. There's someone out there who likes seeing you without the so much cleavage showing, so much of your butt showing, or your stomach, or so much skin showing. Times when you're just like, hair in a bun, no makeup, you know? Well, I have mascara on, so I can't say no makeup, but... And when you're dressed like me, oh my gosh. Okay, you see this? I'm wearing a yellow long sleeve with messy shorts and my socks and shoes. People like seeing you like this sometimes. Don't always try so hard, okay? Because it's gonna be good for you in the end. And here's the thing that I've kind of lived by. My mom would tell me, I don't want you wearing so much makeup all the time because, or not so much makeup, because I never wear a lot of makeup because I don't even know how to do makeup. She would be like, I don't want you to wear any foundation or anything like that besides like mascara. She's like, I don't want you wearing any of that now because when it comes to dances and stuff, if you're like trying hard every day in school and like wearing the makeup, the full on makeup, doing your hair every day, what about when you go to your dances and stuff? You're not gonna look any more special or any different because you're just looking the same every day. So when you go to your dance wearing that buttload of makeup, it's just gonna be like, oh, we see her like that all the time, it's nothing special. So it's better to not wear so much makeup when you're in school and not try so hard when you're in school. So that way when you go to a dance or something and you're wearing all that makeup and your hair is all done and your nails and your clothes is like fancy, it's like, wow, oh my gosh, we just seen like a different side of her. Like, this girl can be really beautiful like both ways, you know? It's kind of something that I've kind of lived by, even though I've wore foundation a couple times at school, but that's because I'm really insecure sometimes. If you see me wear foundation to school, it's because I'm feeling insecure that day. If people are calling you fat or you think you're fat or something, like, just ignore them because you should be happy with the way you look, okay? Like, they're just dumb. And if someone calls you fat, don't let it get to you. If someone says you're too skinny, don't let that get to you. If someone says you're ugly, don't let that get to you. If someone says you have really bad acne, don't let that get to you. Like, look at this. I don't even care that this is showing. Like, if I really cared, then I would cover this up with freaking foundation or something, because honestly, you just need to learn to be happy with what you have now and what you have with yourself, because that can make you feel so much better in so many ways, and you know, that can help you through a lot of things. Your biggest bully is yourself, and it's really sad. You look at yourself every day, you see yourself every day, that you start noticing every little aspect on yourself that's just wrong. But other people don't see that, so if you're seeing it, then, oh, well, that's what, like, it, just ignore it, just love yourself, like, oh, this little pimple here, hey, little pimple, like, you're my best friend now. I make no sense. I'm tired of being super serious. I don't like being serious. I'm not a serious person. I just found my scrunchie. I found my favorite scrunchie. I shot that at myself. This color doesn't make sense right now, but do I care? No. Video is gonna be very long just because I'm being really stupid and I talk a lot because I'm really annoying and loud and obnoxious. I see so many people now who are out getting drunk all the time, or out getting high all the time, out getting themselves into trouble, out having sex every week with different men. Like, ugh. Why are people so dumb now? I know some people who get high and get drunk just to get away from all their thoughts and feelings. But I don't think that's really the best way. I think that you need to find someone that you can talk to about all your thoughts and your feelings and, like, show them how you feel. But make sure it's someone who's actually willing to be there and talk to you about it. Make sure they're not there just to reply to your problems. I have people like that where I'm going through rough times and I'll try to talk to them about what I'm feeling and my thoughts and everything, and they just reply. They're not there to understand or didn't know how I feel or help me. They're just there to be like, oh yeah, I understand, or oh yeah, I get that. I think our generation isn't fully messed up. Our generation is still pretty cool. We still got good parts about it. A lot of it's messed up. I hear my mom's stories and, like, all my friends' parents' stories of how they were when they were little kids, and they were getting into trouble, too. I think teenagers have been the same throughout all the years, but in ways it's just developed. With us, it's the social media, the internet, all that stuff. We follow the crowd rather than making our own stories or making our own paths. Oh, yeah, the new slangs these days are freaking retarded. Okay, es get it? Cringe just thinking of that word. I hate that freaking word. Why is that a thing? Like, just say let's get it. Or when people text me and say probably, I'm like, stop saying probably. Do not ever say probably. Just say probably. It's easy. Remember someone wrote all that? It's all that. It's simple. You don't have to shorten it and put all that. Those are things that bother me and that I won't ever do, but if other people do them, then you're doing it. It's you. It's already like 30 minutes long on my thing, even though it'll probably be shorter on YouTube. So.